guys right here are vortex filters. Retail, they'd be about $4,000 a piece. DIY version, about $100. You might be able to do it for cheaper. We've got a 55-gallon drum with a cone built into it, down into a shower drain. Out here, you can pull off your fertilizer every day for your garden. I'll show you about that.
We're pulling off a pretty incredible fertilizer. We had it tested at the University of Columbia. The 10-6-2 fertilizer with a ton of micronutrients. Right here is our aquaponics system with IBC totes. We're going to be focusing on the four cylinders on the back side of the system. These are our vortex filters, and we're going to show you how to build them from scratch. We have a pretty intense system, so we've built some really intense filtration, but you'll want to think about these processes. Stage one, you want to settle out as much of the solids as you can before you send it to your mechanical filter so you don't have to change your filter pads all the time. So we built this vortex filter where the water spins real slow, the solids settle to the bottom, we pull them off as fertilizer every day. Stage two, whatever solids sneak by get caught in four filter pads so that the only thing left to filter now is the ammonia. Stage three is the biological filter. It's where you create a lot of surface area for bacteria to grow. Ours is a bead filter. You might do a sand filter or a trickle filter. After stage three, the ammonia is turned into nitrate. It's pumped up to the plants. In stage four, the plants use the nitrate and send it back clean. And you could do this on a much simpler level. We wouldn't even need the vortex filters if we just had 100 fish instead of 1,000. The rocks in the grow bed would do most of the biological filtration, and we just have to clean it out, whatever solids got caught up in there. But we are on a mission to create organic fertilizer and harvest it. So how did we build it?
All right, we make our vortex filters out of 55-gallon drums. You're gonna have to pick up one of these 55-gallon drums. This one here had vanilla in it. You wanna make sure it's food grade. We picked it up $15, got four of them for $60. And the first thing you do is plumb in the shower drain right here. So we thought we'll drill a 3-inch hole. Come to find out, you run into all sorts of problems when you drill in. Here's what we drilled out. It's got a humongous bump in it. It's anything but flat. So if you're trying to plumb that shower drain in, you're gonna leak. You're gonna leak real bad because it's just not a flat surface. So we had to figure out a way. What do we do? You know. So we went to go buy some new drums. Looked and looked and went to four or five different places and could not find a single drum that was flat. Found some that were more flat, but still, you know, it was rough and wavy. Just, I guess it's just part of the plastic process. So I racked my brain. I went up to the metal shop looking for a giant 8-foot C-clamp and couldn't find it. So I thought, man, I've got to make my own tool to iron this plastic out, heat it up. It was a total theory. I halfway believed it would work. And I found these two metal plates right here. They just were plain metal plates, and I thought, man, if I get these holes drilled in it and weld on some bolts, tighten it down, put it together, it's, you know, while I'm tightening it and heating it with a torch, it'll iron that plastic out. And so I went down to the machine shop, paid him $20. He drilled me perfect three holes right here in the middle of this circle I drew for him, and boom. We got a plastic vise and it worked.
Okay, what we're doing now is heating up these plates, which we're gonna use to flatten out the bottom of these 55-gallon drums, kind of like what we've done over here on these. So I've drilled some holes to put the plate on both sides, getting the plates real hot. I'm gonna flatten out these barrels so we can plumb the bottom of them in.
Now we're tightening this up. One by one. Don't tighten any one of them up too tight before you go to the next one. Just get it snug, 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 snug. Keep going around. And then he's heating it from the inside. We're looking for it to start melting around this edge. But it happens really fast, so you want to pull off before the whole thing melts through and you ruin your drum. Then you're going to keep heating it, switching back between tightening it up, heating it, tightening it up until it you get that bead of melted plastic around the edge. Then you might have to run outside and hose it down before it melts all the way through. Okay, I'm starting to get a little bead. You probably can't see it in video. Right there, that little clear plastic bead. And there might be a better way to do this. I don't know, I'm just kind of shooting from the hip here, but we're about completely flat here. I've been tightening it up and heating it up. And you can go too far really fast here. So I better pay attention. See that bead bubbling out on the edges there? Just where we want to stop. Next thing you're going to want to do after you flatten the bottom of your barrel out is drill a hole with a hole saw. We're using a 3 1/4 inch hole saw. You got to make sure it's real sharp. You want that shower drain to just fit through there, not too tight, but not loose. You want as much ceiling surface area as you can. So you'll drill that hole, you'll plumb your shower drain in, you'll make sure you have that gasket underneath the barrel. You might put one on top, but definitely one underneath. Use a bunch of pipe dope. You'll put a pipe dope on all these threads, plumb that thing in there, and then put your tank up on blocks. Put your 55-gallon barrel up on blocks. Throw a plug in there. We picked up one of these plugs for $2. You have to check it to make sure it doesn't leak before you throw a bunch of concrete in there and waste your barrel. Fill it full of water, check it out, make sure it doesn't leak, and then you'll be ready to move forward. So this is what your cone is going to look like before you rivet it together. Every cone is going to be different. Every barrel is different. So you got your upper diameter and your lower diameter for your shower drain. It's a crazy equation. We got it from this guy. He used to build rocket bodies for the U.S. Army, and he had to figure out how to cone down from a bigger cylinder to a smaller cylinder. So hit up the wiki. We've got the cone calculator. All you got to do is type in the upper diameter and the lower diameter and the height of your cone. Make sure you've got at least a 45 degree angle coming down so that the solids will fall. It's on our website, theurbanfarmingguys.com. Hit up the knowledge base and don't give yourself a headache trying to figure out the cone all by yourself.
Next, we built a wood stand for our filter to sit on. It's just four legs made out of 4x4s and a plywood top with a hole cut out for the shower drain to come through. Then we plumbed off of that a valve. We've made the whole thing high enough for a 5-gallon bucket to go underneath it to pull the fish waste off. Next, drop your cone right into the barrel and center it over the drain hole. Then take a Sharpie marker and trace around the top of the cone. You'll use this mark as a guide when you're putting down the cement base. Then pull your cone out and mix up your cement. When your cement perlite mix is ready, cut a PVC pipe to the length of your cone wall and use it to form the base. Then after it's nice and cone-shaped, let it set for 3 days to dry. Come back, mix up some thin-set mortar, spread it all over the cone, set your cone in, push down till the mortar squeezes all around the sides, clean it up, and let it sit for 3 more days. Then come back, caulk it, wait for the caulk to dry, and you've got a cone bottom filter.
So here's our inlet and outlet pipe. This whole thing's been made possible by these magical uniseals. Instead of spending $100 on a bulkhead fitting, we're able to use these rubber uniseals, $5 a piece. Our inlet pipe is plumbed it's on a rule of thirds here. This is the top of the cone. We come up a third from there and then come down a third, and this is our outlet pipe here.
You're going to get hard turn 90s, this is as hard as I could find, and make them low profile, cutting them down so they turn inside of your filter here. Let me show you. And you don't need to use any kind of glue. Actually, I'm going to drain this and cut it even shorter. And real soon we'll start to get a vortex here. They'll start to turn. So here's what the finished product looks like. You can see the pipe coming in at the top is the outlet pipe. You can see the little tornado above it, the little vortex that shows it's working. This is where the water exits the tank. The pipe right below it is the inlet pipe. That's where the water comes in. It takes a hard right and starts slowly spinning in the tank. The solids settle out and the clean water at the top is pulled off and sent to the second filter. So rewind a little bit. We're going to show you how to install a uniseal on the practice barrel.
Before you drill your hole, you're going to want to stick a support board in there, like so, and then drill right next to it, right there. Okay, right now we're putting a beveled edge on the edge of these PVC pipes so that they'll be able to slide through the uniseal.
Then you just pop the uniseal in the hole, push the pipe through. You got to lubricate it a little bit with some WD-40. If you go too far, it's one directional. You got to go all the way through, start again, and push to where you need it.
Just enough to get our elbow in there. And then we're going to put one up higher for the outlet pipe.
And there you go. Vortex technology is now in your hands. If you need a parts list, come check out the wiki on the webpage. Stay tuned for part 2 where we build a mechanical filter and a bead filter. And come ask questions on the forum. We are here for you.